Okay. So here we are. So let's elaborate on this a little bit more so we can see how this all ties together. Because there is a, you know, even as all of us on the Restore America plan, the movement, the whole movement, this includes, you know, all of us talk show people, all of us that have websites and organizations to help each other, and this and that, you know. The last two that I educated myself in were the Gordon Hall School of Thought and the Tim Turner School of Thought. And in fact, there's a website called Creators and Commerce. It's got Brandon Adam Alexander's. He's heading that up. But we have Jack Smith in there, Gordon Hall, and they give their, you know, their information that they have. And on the website, I noticed in some of their conferences that they have Tim Turner conferences listed. And so it seemed to me that Brandon Adams, Gordon Hall, and Jack Smith probably are aware with the Restore America plan and this and that. And so they're both, you know, doing what they can in their areas to see what can be done. But the prevalent school of thought with Gordon Hall, who was one of the more predominant speakers showing skill in the recordings, although Jack Smith has his skills, but his recordings have to be gotten some other way. But anyway, the predominant, prevalent thought that Gordon Hall was using was the old traditional indoctrinated way of using the parables of Yeshua. And he would always go to Matthew chapter 5 and explain how we are to agree with thine adversary quickly as it applied to the process that he and others have discovered. That has to do with going into court before the judge and just accepting all charges and no arguments and putting the burden of proof on them to prove everything. Just agree with them. Agree with everything they have to say and conditionally accept everything that they have to present so that the condition is placed upon them to provide the burden of the proof. And so, you know, as I'm going through and learning all this stuff, I see, oh, okay, this is all good information for different steps where different people are at. And I could see that, you know, men like me have a very important role to play as far as bringing an education into a proper interpretation of the parables of Yeshua as it relates also to knowledge of the sin. Yeah, I've come to learn Tim Turner's views on the parables of Yeshua too, and Ten Commandments and whatnot. But, you know, like I say, you know, we're all skilled in different areas. And so we're all coming together. We're all coming together and we're all educating one another. And so it's going to take time. And the best thing we can do is just be at peace with each other and just present our sides, you know. And usually the easiest way to present our sides is just to make our own videotapes and just put them out there, as opposed to going on a radio station and starting arguments about what truth might be. Because it's easier for us if we just have a video to watch. We'll watch the video, and as we're sitting there, it's our choice to listen to it. So if we're listening to it, we're more than likely going to be more open to going, oh, wow. Never thought of that. As opposed to when everybody gets on a live radio station all the time together, it's a tendency for our imperfections to really show. And we begin, competition starts when people start getting together and head start button. And it makes for a very unpleasant situation. So I have found a tool, a necessary tool in today's driven society to alleviate lots of the pressures and easy ways to get information across. You know, sure, there's audios, but who likes watching a black screen all the time? It's nice to have a video so we can see the person talking in a personal video, you know, in a personal setting. And then as we start educating and learning and more people start talking about it and start having more people start waking up to what the real truth is, because from what I found, there is one real truth, is the way the earth was run, and that's common law. I'm finding that more and more. And I've also found there's one truth as far as our belief system goes, is it equates to the Most High, our Creator, and all these things that He's created for us. There's only one truth. There's only one way to do it. There's only one way that it works. There's only one way that it works. Only one way. And so, like I said, we'll get there. And I'm gonna spend a little more time on Matthew 25, because this has been one of the prevalent things that the Gordon Hall Brandon Adams School of Thought has come to. Well, one thing I've noticed in the Tim Turner School of Thought, he doesn't agree with them at all. He just brings the common law right to him and says, look, man, you're disobeying even your own rules or whatever. The Rod Class School of Thought, you know, he takes their own rules and puts it in their, you know, in education in that area. Or the Carl Westons and this, and that. And the Chris Summers and, you know, I could name them all. There's everybody in the movements, and we all know who they are. We all know each other. But these are just names that came to the top of my head. So, this is accomplishable to me. This is all accomplishable for a time. And I said, and I say this too, in reference to the postponement that we've all been praying about and desiring to restore order on earth for a time, and to bring postponement to the evils, to the dark side, to Satan and his followers, you know, those in the hierarchy of the fourth foul Jesuits and everybody in their chain of commands, the Satanists, Luciferians, everybody. We are bringing a postponement to their control by gaining favor in the Most High's eyes at this time, period of time on earth. And it's my belief that we are in the very last times, and Yahweh is showing us favor because of our, as a people, wanting to return to what truth is and operating in truth the way it's mainly supposed to be beneficial for those of us on earth to live peaceful lives. And like I said, you know, it's a postponement to their control, because they will eventually get their total control. And I know that that's going to be after the rapture has happened and Holy Spirit believers are taken out of the earth, so that there's no